That girl don't kill me, can only make me stronger. I need you to hurry up now, cause I can't wait much longer. I know I got to be right now, cause I can't get much stronger. Man, I've been waiting all night now, that's how long I've been on ya.
Happy New Year, everybody, from the Aflac Cup Series. Hope everyone has a great 2016. Now, it's time to go racing at the Daytona International Speedway on New Year's Eve, 2015. The last day of the year, and we have a race under the lights here, getting ready for a big celebration as we ring in the new year and crown a new winner or a repeat winner in the Season 7 of the Aflac Cup Series. 43 cars will be on this track this evening, and now we're going to check out your drivers to watch for. Dale Earnhardt Jr., always a threat when you come to the restrictor plate tracks. He'll be a threat to reckon with today. Trevor Bayne won the Daytona 500 here last July. Can he win another one? And then Joey Logano won the Daytona 500 in the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series. He's good at the restrictor plate tracks. Now time for the command. Drivers, start your engines. Cars fire up, and now they'll roll off here for 9 laps in Daytona Beach. Here's your starting lineup. Row 1, Matt the Brat Kenseth and Dale Earnhardt Jr. Row 2, all aboard the Bayne train, it's Trevor Bayne and Tony Smoke Stewart. Row 3, Dub F and Eric Almirola. Row 4, Ryan Blaney and 6-time champ Jimmy Johnson. Row 5, Joey Logano and Brian Scott. Row 6, Regan Smith and Ricky Stenhouse Jr. Row 7, Kurt Busch and Ryan Newman. Row 8, Danica Patrick and Paul Menard. Row 9, Martin Truex Jr. and Jeff Gordon. Row 10, Camden Luca and Kyle Larson. Row 11, David Gillen and Kyle Busch. Row 12, Austin Dillon and Flippy Carl Edwards. Row 13, Jimmy and Eddie Jones. Row 14, Bryce Harvey and Gino Harvey, both starting in the same row, back-to-back weeks. Row 15, Carter Adelman and Brad Keselowski. Row 16, Denny Hamlin and Casey Kane. Row 17, Kevin Harvick and Jamie McMurray. Row 18, David Reagan and Chase Elliott. Row 19, A.J. Allmendinger and Casey Mears. Row 20, Clint Boyer and Sam Harness Jr. Row 21, Alex Bowman and Josh Wise. And then row 22 is Landon Castle. Now we're going to check out, time to go green flag racing in Daytona. Matt Kenseth and Dale Jr. lead him to the line. They head into turn one. Kenseth's got the advantage over second place Dale Jr., who now battles with Trevor Bayne for the second spot. Tony Stewart and Jr. are going to get that high line working down the backstretch and into 3 and 4. Jr. ducks slow, but Kenseth shuts the door. Kenseth pulling out to a decent-sized lead here on lap one. Stewart gets a run, crossing the checkers. Kenseth stops his momentum. Now Dale Jr. evens up into second place, battling with Tony Stewart. They go down the backstretch, make contact. Kenseth gets loose, and he falls backwards through the middle of the pack. Now Trevor Bayne and Greg Biffle on the inside line, trying to catch Dale Jr. and Tony Stewart. Here comes Regan Smith, making a 3-wide back for fifth position. And now Eric Amarola's got a good run coming on him. Oh, we got a crash. Danica Patrick flips over. Kenseth involved. Camden Luca, it looks like. And Martin Truex Jr. and others involved in this crash. Watch as Danica Patrick gets into Trevor Bayne. Trevor Bayne goes to the inside wall. Truex up the track. Kurt Busch and Danica Patrick also in the wreck. A lot of cleanup. Let's check out another look at this. Watch Danica Patrick go up into the wall with her boyfriend, Ricky Stenhouse Jr., and she flips over. So red flag conditions, we're going to have a lot of cleanup here. Ryan Blaney and Brian Scott looking to have an upset one today. Martin Truex Jr. wrecks back-to-back weeks. Danica Patrick flips over. Here's Danica's tumble once again. Ouch, what a hard crash for Danica Patrick. Kurt Busch was involved as well. Same with Ricky Stenhouse Jr., Trevor Bayne. All the Roush cars were involved in this wreck. And they had very strong cars today. I mean, Roush is usually pretty good at the Daytona Super Speedways. Matt Kenseth involved, David Gillen. And so the cars will get back rolling here. And we're going to go back green flag racing after all the cleanup's done. Here we go. Dale Jr. and Eric Almirola lead him to the line. Down the backstretch they go through turns 1 and 2 as well. Oh, it's Casey Kane making a 3 wide in the back of the pack. Here they come through out of turn 4. Eric Almirola grabs the lead. And Regan Smith will jump into that second position. Regan Smith having a great day. Looking to go for the lead with Dale Jr. Regan Smith gets the help from Dale Jr. and he rockets to the lead. But Jr. hangs him out to dry. Dale Jr. wants the lead again and Dale Jr. will take it. On lap 6 of 9, Paul Menard coming up through the pack now. Joey Logano going around the outside of Paul Menard. Oh, we got a crash! Big wreck in turn 2. It's Jeff Gordon involved with Jimmy Johnson, Brad Keselowski, and Regan Smith. Watch as Regan Smith gets into Jeff Gordon. Up in the wall they go. Gordon tumbles around. Carter Adelman does a great job of missing that wreck. So Jimmy Johnson goes on the wrecker. Along with Regan Smith, Jeff Gordon gets hauled to the garage, and same with Brad Keselowski. We got 3 laps to go in Daytona. This is going to get exciting. Here we go. Green flag is out. 3 to go in Daytona. Dale Jr. leads him to the line with Paul Menard. Paul Menard gets a great start. So does Joey Logano. They go 3 wide into turn 1. 3 wide down the backstretch for the race lead. It's Dale Jr., Logano, and Menard. Logano gets help with a push of Gino Harvey. Here comes Tony Stewart. And Dale Jr. now fighting back on the inside line. 2 laps to go. Here comes Austin Dillon to help Dale Jr. out for the race lead. But Joey Logano blocks. Joey Logano trying to win this race. But Gino Harvey's got the surge on the outside with his teammates Carter Adelman and Jimmy. Carter Adelman and Jimmy push Gino Harvey to the lead with 1 lap to go. Here they come down through the line. Just 1 lap remaining in Daytona. Dale Jr., he's trying to get on the high side. He's going to tuck in line. This is what Gino Harvey wants. But Paul Menard gets a run. Dale Jr. jumps out of line. Here they come. They're turn 3 and 4 1 last time. Dale Jr. is going to look to the high side. Carter Adelman ducks low. We got a wreck in the back. And Dale Jr. wins. Dale Jr. wins at Daytona with a big crash heading to the line. What a finish. Watch as Dale Jr. gets a surge of momentum as Joey Logano spins around in the back. And Jr. takes the victory. And Joey Logano spins around. Eric Almirola was involved. He got hit in the wall hard there with Eddie Jones and Kyle Larson. Bryce Harvey involved. Kyle Busch. Landon Castle. Oh, such a lot of torn up race cars coming to the line. This is what we hate to see. And NASCAR is torn up cars coming to the line. So Chase Elliott involved, Eric Almirola. These drivers had such great runs going, and then they just get torn up at the end. But Dale Jr. wins at Daytona for the second time this year. Good congratulations, Dale Earnhardt Jr. What a victory, winning in the Sprint Cup Series and the AFLAC Cup Series, the night race in Daytona. Now your point standings after race 18 out of 36. We're halfway through the season. Jeff Gordon, he is first with those 3 wins, and then you see Dale Jr. jump up to the 5th. Carl Edwards, last week's winner, is down to 6th because the junior has more points than him. 7th is Brad Keselowski, 8th Carter Adelman. Now you can check out your chase cutoff. Joey Logano, 128 points to the good. Yes, I said that correctly. 128 points. Gino Harvey moves up just 14 points behind Kurt Busch. And Austin Dillon moving closer as well. He was 35 points behind last week. Now he's just 19. So here's your 22nd through 30th. Bryce Harvey in 22nd. Eddie Jones, 23rd. Almirola, 24th. Stewart, 25th. Kenseth, 26th. Ryan Newman, 27th. Clint Boyer, 28th. Paul Menard jumping into the top 30 this week in 29th. And then Casey Mears in 30th. Greg Biffle falls out of the top 30, but he's pretty close to Casey Mears, who's just 7 points behind. Danica Patrick still falling. She's got that one win, but for it to count, she needs to get inside that top 30. And that's going to be a tough task to do with this tough competition in the AFLAC Cup Series. Brian Scott in 44th, you see, as he had a wreck on lap 3. Terrible finish for him, but he had a good car. I'll give him that. Been 51st through 50th, right? 55th right there. Now your finishing results. First today was Dale Earnhardt Jr. Congratulations, Dale Jr. First win of the season at Daytona. Then second today was Carter. Third was a good run by Gino Harvey. Fourth, Jimmy, finishing 3 cars in the top 5 for Team Magi. Fifth today, Paul Menard. Great car for Paul. That was a good run for Paul. Sixth was Stewart. Can't say enough about how his effort today. 30th today was Danica Patrick. 41st was Martin Truex Jr. 42nd, Brian Scott. 43rd ended up being Ryan Blaney. And then next week we'll be at the Jeff Gordon Speedway under the lights yet again. So we'll have fun there. And this is JG24, JM26, signing out. Come on, Chloe, say goodbye. Say goodbye.